Hodgkins here, and we are on to Happy Horse Challenge number 11. So this one is 4 feet on a pedestal. The goal is, can your horse stand with all 4 feet on a pedestal when you send him to it? The benefits, this is a cool challenge and has a lot of practical benefits too. By stepping up and down, it prepares your horse for trailer loading. It tests your horse's balance and awareness of their feet, of where their feet are, and helps to refine your communication. This is also a fun challenge to start on the ground and eventually riding. If you sign up for a lot of trail competitions, they usually have some sort of pedestal or bridge or something for your horse to stand up on. This is one of those things you want to make sure that your horse doesn't take over and immediately, as soon as they see a pedestal, want to go to it and stand on it. I've seen a girl get in a kind of a bit of a wreck, and the horse got pretty scunned up when that happened. So, she kind of headed there, and I just said, I'm not ready yet. It's amazing how in tune these horses are. I'm just going to send her around this way, so she can be kind of sideways to you. This little pedestal that we have here, she won it. In 2016, Peter Whittemore put on a step-up challenge, and it came down to her and a miniature donkey, and it was a one-by-one pedestal that they had to get on, and you had like 30 seconds to get on it, and she did fantastic. I think we came home with $200 and this pedestal. All right, so I'm gonna allow her to figure it out. Gotta get her feet kind of to the front of it. Really good. Good girl. Very good. All right, and I'll just have her come back off. When you're playing with this, think about straightness. How straight did your horse get on? How straight did they come off? Did you see her nose head to that pedestal? So she's thinking, pedestal, I gotta stand on it. I'm gonna say, like Dave Ellis says, wait for orders from headquarters. One thing I want you guys to think about is Linda Perelli came up with this the last time she was in New Hampshire. She had mentioned, does your horse know the goal? And the pedestal is a really good example of that. So when you send your horse to the pedestal, it's pretty quick they know the goal. And they kind of do it on their own. So you're not letting them, you're allowing them to get on the pedestal. Think about that in other parts of your horsemanship. So whether it's to go sideways over a pole on the ground or sideways over a barrel, does your horse know the goal? Can you set it up and ask them to do it and have them perform whatever the task is? So I'm gonna try that with her and back her up a little bit. I'm gonna think I'd like you to be on that pedestal. Suggested to her once to do it. Good. And I will say, can you come off? So what we're going to do, do you see her want to go back on there? So be aware of where your horse is and what they're thinking. We're going to grab Rocky, that younger horse I have, and we're going to do it with him. And I've played with this, again, everything in this book is things that I do with all my horses all the time. So we're gonna pull him out again, and I'm sure he's gonna need a refresher. We've only done it once where he got all 4 feet up on there. And if you wanna see what we had done to get that done, you can go to my Facebook page and all the videos are there. All right, thank you. All right, so George took out Smooch, and George has been working with this with him. And so we're just gonna see what today brings. Does he understand the goal? Whoa. Pretty good. Very nice.
I wouldn't worry
So I want you to think about when your horse goes to step up on something, what does their body have to do? Notice how Smooch might have to lower his head to shift his weight to come forward. What does your horse have to do to prepare their body to get on that pedestal? It's not about the pedestal. It's preparing him to get on the pedestal. He tried. Good job. And we're gonna do the 4 feet on the pedestal challenge with him. We'll see how he does today. And again, this is not the first time that I've done this with him. The things that are in those 52 challenges books are things that I do with all my horses all the time. It really does prepare them for a trailer. It gets them knowing where their feet are, getting on and off things. And like I said, in any competition, any trail competition, usually they have some sort of pedestal. So we'll just kind of see what happens, see what shapes up, and then we'll see where I can maybe help him in some areas if he needs it. All right, so the goal for this challenge is confidence. And they do that with the front foot or the back foot. Cool. on either side of your horse. This is really good for horses that don't like their feet picked up for the farrier. Good. So can I pick up his foot and bring it forward? If he needs a little help coming forward, I'll use the halter. So these are a couple little things that you can do. All right, now we'll go back to the pedestal. Nice looking chew. So right now we're going to try this. And just take your time experimenting with what it might be that your horse needs for more information. Another change of direction. So I don't mind if he comes down to a walk through that change of direction, but when he gets done, I'm going to ask him to kind of hustle out of it. Kind of cruise along. About those feet. Try to mix it up a little bit. Back here, get straight.
We're at 14 minutes.
14 minutes, right? So you just kind of make things all work together and don't make it a big deal about the pedestal. Just think, what else can I work on? Is he worried about the pedestal and I need to worry about confidence? Or can I work on something else so that the pedestal looks like a really good place to be? And anything you do, just remember, like Joe Walter says, there is no right or wrong. No good or bad, there's just things that work and things that don't work. So don't be afraid to experiment and try different things. That's all I got for you, so have fun with this challenge. There. Good. So what did it take to get that try in her?
I had to ask her a little bit more forward instead of just using my stick. Because using my stick, she was like, oh, it's just a friendly game.
You got it. So just be aware of what caused that.